Hello, my name is Ivy. I'm a fourth year social work student at Toronto Metropolitan University. I'm currently completing my placement with the Organization for a Safer Space. Today, I'll be talking about intermittent explosive disorder. In this video, we'll first look at what intermittent explosive disorder is. We'll then look at some statistics, risk factors and causes, signs and symptoms, effects, treatment, and lastly, we'll look at some coping strategies. Intermittent explosive disorder has been described since the beginning of the Diagnostic and Statistical Manual of Mental Disorders, or the DSM. In previous versions of the DSM, it was referred to as passive-aggressive personality and explosive personality. It received its current name in 1980 and was included as one of the impulse control disorders. Intermittent explosive disorder is a mental health condition defined by episodes of impulsive anger outbursts or aggression, which are disproportionate to the stressor event. People with intermittent explosive disorder have a low tolerance to adversity and frustration. Thus, they can have episodes that can include temper tantrums, verbal assault, such as screaming or threatening others, physical assault, such as slapping, punching, or hammering others with weapons, destructive or non-destructive property assault, such as throwing, breaking, or kicking objects, road rage, and domestic violence. These outbursts can cause significant distress, relationship issues, and occupational problems. Intermittent explosive disorder is suggested to be heritable and linked to serotonin dysregulation. It can affect children as young as 6 and as old as 40. Intermittent explosive disorder affects males more than females. Statistics. It is estimated that intermittent explosive disorder occurs in 5.4% of the United States population, 4.9% of the Brazilian population, 2.1% of the Japanese population, and in 1.7% of the Iraq population. Approximately 80% of people with intermittent explosive disorder have another mental health condition. Intermittent explosive disorder co-occurs with anxiety disorders, intellectual disabilities, autism, externalizing disorder, mood disorders, substance use disorders, and bipolar disorder. Studies have found that the most frequent comorbid disorder was alcohol abuse, depression, anxiety, and bipolar disorders. It has been found that intermittent explosive disorder affects 1 in 12 adolescents, making it one of the most common diagnosed mental health conditions in young people. Risk factors and causes. According to researchers, there are genetic, biological, and environmental factors that contribute to the development of intermittent explosive disorder. In regard to genetic factors, studies have found that the likelihood of developing intermittent explosive disorder is 44% to 72% genetic. In terms of the biological factors, MRI studies have shown that intermittent explosive disorder affects the amygdala, which is associated with emotional functioning. Additional studies suggest that people with this disorder have lower serotonin levels. In regard to environmental factors, experiencing or witnessing a traumatic event during childhood, including verbal and physical abuse, plays a role in the development of intermittent explosive disorder. Other risk factors include being a young male, unemployment, lower educational levels, experiences of sexual violence in childhood, history of brain trauma, exposure to neglect, and a family history of another mental health disorder. Signs and symptoms. The most significant sign of intermittent explosive disorder includes patterns of anger outbursts that are disproportionate to the triggering event. Aggressive outbursts are impulsive, occur quickly after provocation, last less than 30 minutes, create significant distress, create school, work, and/or home issues. There are several behavioral, physical, cognitive, and psychosocial symptoms of intermittent explosive disorder. Besides aggressive outbursts, behavioral symptoms include verbal defiance, physical aggression, harming animals, damaging property, and self-harm. Physical symptoms include physical injuries, rapid heart rate, muscle tension, headaches, numbness, tremors, and chest tightness. Cognitive symptoms include a lack of impulse control, hearing echoes, and racing thoughts. And lastly, psychosocial symptoms include feeling that one will lose control at any moment, irritability, emotional detachment, guilt, shame, agitation, rage, and low frustration tolerance. Effects. Intermittent explosive disorder can radically affect someone's life if not treated. Studies suggest that intermittent explosive disorder can last from 12 to 20 years to even a lifetime. People who have intermittent explosive disorder are subject to low life satisfaction and lower quality of life. If it persists, it can lead to poor social interactions, isolation, increased conflicts, academic decline, criminal activity, self-harm, suicide, and development of other conditions such as depression, anxiety, substance use disorder, and alcohol use disorder. Treatment. The treatment for intermittent explosive disorder usually includes psychotherapy, also known as talk therapy, which aims to change thoughts that contribute to anger and aggression. A type of psychotherapy that is commonly used to treat this disorder is cognitive behavioral therapy, or CBT. With CBT, a therapist helps the patient to examine the thoughts and emotions, and how the thoughts affect their actions. With this therapy, one can unlearn negative thoughts and behaviors, and learn positive and healthier ones instead. The CBT techniques for intermittent explosive disorder can include cognitive restructuring, which aims to change disrupted thoughts about triggering situations and perceived threats. Relaxation training, which includes using deep breathing and muscle relaxation techniques to reduce one's response to triggers. Coping skills training, which involves role-playing situations that can cause an episode and responding in a healthier manner. And relapse prevention. This includes enlightening people with intermittent explosive disorder that the reoccurrence of their aggressive behavior is common for their condition, and that it should be seen as a lapse instead of a failure. Depending on the age and symptoms, treatments can involve medication. The classes of medication for intermittent explosive disorder are antidepressants, antipsychotics, anti-anxiety medications, and mood regulators. Coping strategies. To prevent episodes of anger and aggression, it is important for a person with intermittent explosive disorder to learn techniques for relaxation, improve their communication skills, and change their environment during an episode. This can include walking away. It is also imperative for those diagnosed with this disorder to avoid recreational drugs and alcohol. If you have any of the symptoms described in this video, it is important to seek help. Feel free to check out the organization For a Safer Space at forasaferspace.org, where you can have access to accessible, affordable, and affirming mental health care with licensed mental health professionals. Thank you for watching and have a great day.